everybody, it's Annie and welcome to my backyard. Today we're going to be talking about the deep litter method for your chicken coop. What it is, why I use it, how to maintain it, and then what to do with all that bedding and chicken poop when you're going to clean it out. The deep litter method is honestly what some people say is the lazy person's way to clean your coop, but really, I just think it's awesome. Instead of scooping out chicken poop out of the bottom of your coop like every couple days, the deep litter method provides a way where you can sprinkle shavings, pine shavings preferably, or whatever it is, just stay away from cedar, and sprinkling a little coop recuperate. And then as you go, you add to that as your chickens poop. Then you add more shavings on top, more recuperate. And your chickens will just naturally stir it. And by the time you're finished with 6 months or whatever it may be, you have this really awesome nutrient-rich compost for your gardens. And honestly, it allows me to spend a lot more time with my chickens instead of scraping poop all the time. Because as we know, chickens poop so much. This method for cleaning your chicken coop not only takes advantage of not having to deal with all the gross chicken things, it actually provides an awesome environment for microbes and things like that to eat all the icky bacteria that could cause you or your chickens to be sick. Depending on how many chickens you have in your flock, you'll want to clean out your coop every 4 to 6 months or so. Some people pick once a year, some people pick, you know, twice a year or quarterly, you know, spring, fall. That really just depends on how many birds you have and how messy they are. Because let me tell you something about chickens. If you want your chicken coop to look like the magazines or the ones on TV, don't put chickens in there because they're messy. And so just keep that in mind as you go, that no matter what you do as far as coop cleaning, you're going to have to just embrace the fact that chickens are dusty and they cause a big mess. So I'm going to break this down for you into 4 easy steps to set up your deep litter method in your coop. The first thing you want to do is to clean out your coop. And what we did is picked a really nice day where there was kind of a breeze. You know, I guess you can't be too picky, but make it a nice day. Put your old clothes on. Make sure you have a mask because honestly, breathing in that chicken dust is not good for you. And so that's what we did first. And then we pulled everything out of the coop. That includes your feeders, your waterers, any toys you might have. I hadn't hung my signs up yet, so I pulled all those out. And then we really got to work. So step 2, now that you have all that icky bedding out of there, what I do is I just take a paint scraper, because you know, there's poop everywhere, you guys. So you just kind of scrape it off. If there's little dried spots, honestly, I didn't have too many because the deep litter method works that well. But I did scrape off some of the surfaces on the floor and got that ready. And then the next thing I did was take some warm soapy water and I just scrubbed out the coop and then I hosed it all off. And after that, I was really messy, but it was actually really fun. So then you just want to make sure you have a good breeze blowing through there or fans or whatever you got, because you want your coop really nice and dry before you go to the next step. So step 3 is, after my coop is all dry, you know that it's really important for chickens to stay clean and dry, so make sure it's all dried out. Then you're going to want to sprinkle 3 to 4 inches of pine shavings or some other form of bedding, but just make sure you stay away from cedar shavings, because cedar shavings contain oils that give off fumes that can really harm your chicken's respiratory system. And then as you go, by the time you're done of these months of just adding bedding to your coop, you'll probably end up with 8 to 12 inches. Okay, step 4 is to sprinkle some coop recuperate liberally over your bedding. You guys, coop recuperate is amazing, like totally amazing. I literally sat on my coop floor while my girls were all cooped up all winter with my chickens. Literally, that happened. Coop recuperate contains organic eucalyptus and lemongrass oils, and it just, so it keeps your coop smelling so fresh and dry. It keeps it dry, and it also is a natural fly repellent. So moving into these warmer months, I'm so excited about that. Literally, you guys, I could snuggle with it. It is that good. It is awesome. So it also, it just, it lengthens the life of your bedding. So just make sure, you know, if you go in your coop and you're like, oh, I might need a little more coop recuperate, just sprinkle it on 1 to 2 times a week or whenever your coop needs it, and you will be so glad that you did. Okay, so now we're going to talk a little bit about how to maintain your coop. You know, really how many times you add litter and how often you do really depends on how many chickens you have. But just watch for it. If you see like a bunch of poop laying on top, just go ahead and add another layer of pine shavings or whatever it may be with some coop recuperate. And also understand that chickens naturally scratch. They just kind of rustle around their bedding. You know, that's just like in them. And also in the wintertime, I actually threw some scratch around and they just turned it all for me. But if they missed a spot, then I just took a garden rake or a hoe and kind of turned it over for them. So that's the idea of it, is just to turn your litter and maintain your coop that way. You guys, it didn't stink. And it was just a great, great way for me to go about our coop keeping. So here's a couple tips for you. Tip number one, when you're looking at coops, make sure that you have a well-ventilated area for your chickens. Chickens poop a lot and their poop gives off this ammonia odor that can really irritate their sinuses and respiratory systems. And so that's the whole reason you want to keep your coop clean and dry and smelling fresh. So make sure you have great ventilation and it will make your chickens a lot healthier, and as well as you if you're going to spend some time out there with them. Tip number two, if you go out to your coop and you're like, woo, it's time to add more bedding. So just add a couple inches or an inch, just enough to cover the poop. Tip number three is that when you are spreading your shavings on top of the bedding, make sure that you do enough. You see, you can't do too much, but you can do too little. So you want to provide a good thick cover to cover all the droppings that are laying on the bottom of the coop. Also, this provides an excellent source of insulation and warmth for your chickens in the winter. Okay, now that we have our coop all cleaned out and all that, everything put back, we're going to talk quickly about composting. Composting is super simple. It's a great way to easily get nutrient-rich material for your garden. So what we did is we took all that chicken poop and bedding out, threw it in a big pile. We put it quite a ways away from our coop because, you know, gross. But then we just let it sit there, you guys. And if you get a strong wind and it's blowing and you're like, ooh, just go add some more dry materials like leaves or grass clippings or something, and it will naturally just break down. Now, if some people stir their compost pile, I don't actually do that. It just breaks down. So, but something to keep in mind, I know you might be in a big hurry to use the compost and it's a really good idea, but if you pull that chicken poop out of your coop hot and throw it right on your little plants, it may actually burn them. So don't, be patient. I know it's hard, but I wait 4 to 6 months actually before I throw my compost on my garden. Okay, call me lazy if you want, but using the deep litter method has worked awesome for me and the girls. So if you want more tips and to follow along on this chicken adventure that we're doing, go check out our YouTube channel, Strong Animals Chicken Essentials. Hug it and kiss it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's what I really want to do.
Right?